Good evening to the zero viewers out there on what very well could be the last game of the 2017-2018 Dominos deildin Icelandic Premier League. Quick recap. Just before the playoffs began, a key injury to Tomasson started things off on the wrong foot, and we ended up matching up against St. Jarnan, which may or may not have been a tougher opponent. May not matter. If you lose, doesn't matter either way. And that's what we're on the brink of doing. Down one game. So let's win or go home. And what happens if we lose remains to be seen. As this is my first playthrough, first season, I have no idea. I can expect that there won't be much fanfare or anything in the game graphics that signifies that it happened. But what hell that brings forth with free agency and then the signing time, we'll see. Could be a redeeming character of this game. Could basically damn it and say, there may not be too many more seasons. I'm just cycling through these results for you. Wait until 11:30. We're really on time. Anybody that's trying to watch this probably knows that. I'm gonna drag it out a little bit. I gotta drag out every other one of those, so. I do have that beer in hand. Finally getting better at this setup. Great that they put a hurting on Yard Vic. It looks like it's safe to say KR, probably Stoffel, and Grindavik. Be awaiting either me or St. Jarman. Grindavik had 5 guys in double figures. Shot pretty well from the floor. Golden State managed to go undefeated the same year that Oklahoma City and the Cavs would have the best record ever. A little bit whack. Hopefully that'll sort itself out a little bit. I think it's just a product of whoever made this mod stacking the deck a little. One of my previous episodes, I think I know I walk through the Golden State Warriors roster and everybody's pretty inflated. Their skill set's great. This is a very good team. Maybe one of the best ever. But not like that. And the Pelicans never had a season like this. So we got Cousins. So I guess it seems a little more realistic, more feasible. Used this exact same team on 2K. But here, I think this was last year. I stripped it and this team was already stripped because I built a fantasy league. Like, I took all the players and put them on 12 fantasy league teams, and I used the Pelicans as a team that was just, like, depleted, trying to get them in the playoffs, and I did. And I stopped playing, and, like, it's one of those games where it's hard, if you haven't played it in a while, to come back and go right back at play at playoff level against one of these stacked fantasy league teams. I think I'm playing the team I put in Yakima Washington has LeBron and Vujovic, like a bunch of people I'm not thinking of, but full of stars. And I'm trying to beat them with Rondo, Solomon Hill. I think I have maybe had Nelson. I don't think so. I think I traded him because the Bulls actually made a trade for him late last year. But Frank Jackson's on there. Miller's on there. Anderson. Kyle Anderson. I don't think he was on there. Anywho, I think we're about that time. Kicking it off here, so definitely keep an eye on what's happening in this league. You know, since we kind of partial with this one. Let's see here just exactly what's going on in the playoffs. Conference semifinals. Cavs swept the Bulls. So it's going to be Cavs Hornets in the conference finals. Warriors and an undecided Thunder versus Rockets matchup. Interesting. So keep tabs on that. And so we're coming down to the game pretty quick. Not a lot of time to mess around with this, so Lamarovic's already great, so I'm okay with what he's doing. Cook, I'll let him do that, and then he's not great tomorrow. Take him down. Anderson probably needs to be. Let's go. 27. I don't really want to jinx it. I guess it's not jinxing it, but maybe making speaking it into existence or. What is it called? A self-fulfilling prophecy. But without Thomason, I don't really know what my expectations were, or should be, whatever, with this team. And since we only lost by a little bit the first game, I feel like they have a chance. But it feels like the odds are stacked against us. And some of my guys, I feel like, have quit on me. Tried to give them, contracts, and they don't want to play. They feel like he's holding them back or something. I don't understand how I'm supposed to assemble a squad other than start focusing more on the academy and the development of them. And then just getting one or two free agents focusing on, for hire mercenaries. Guys like Mike Cook come in and can shoot and score. Have the young core of homebred boys playing the defense, hitting their free throws. Feels very much like how Hoosiers might have been, where they just play defense, shoot free throws. Do that and you have a chance most of the time. So we do have some training progress. Pretty good to see two guys. Asmundsen got slightly better in his 3-point. I continue to feel like this guy should just be a
3 and D specialist. He's got decent speed, 3-point marking needs to come up, so stealing. Focus on that. And he's a guard. Work on those handles a little bit. I don't focus on this too much right now because it's almost the end of the season. Most of the guys on the starting roster should be pulled from activity by this point. Augustin's already perfect, so. Since our backcourt got lit up pretty good, I'm gonna have them all focusing on defensive tactics. Need Cook to continue to bring the firepower. No Maravich's great. I suspect he'll be up to perfect by time. Cook, I'll reduce all activities tomorrow if needed. Let's go. I think there was one guy that had progress. I didn't check him. Maybe that this time around. Thompson got slightly better in his marking. So yeah, these young guys, I mean, we're just breeding a team of the future that thrives on defense, physical, just the raw physical speed and quickness, and free throws, man. No training progress for the 28th. It's all calm here. Right. The night before the big game. Feel the drama. I mean, it's just hanging in the room. Big stalactites. And while the music kind of bleeds through, or all of a sudden it seems more noticeable, I seem to have a limited knowledge about like copyright and how having the music in the background is. I am by no means trying to profit off this, so if it's possible, whatever agency that's representing the people telling me, like LCD sound system made one of my videos on available on YouTube. Like, if I ever make any money, you tell me, like, you want a quarter of it, a percentage of it, I'll give it to you. But I'm not going to make any money. At least for now, just please don't hold my videos hostage. I'll attribute, you can definitely say that it's your song. I'd love that. I can help other people that don't know about your music already know about it. Definitely not trying to claim any of it as my own. So, hopefully I'm not in trouble with any of that. I saw the option on YouTube, like the audio editor to erase or replace a song, and I can't. It's not an option. It says something about that functionality not working currently, but I also wonder if it's just because all this is recorded on one track, like my audio and the music behind it are pretty much intertwined as one. Even just mute those parts, whether it have a problem. What would be great is if you just want to edit my video, you can just put a little stamp that says this song is this band playing right now. You can do that all you want. Whatever. Idea of me somehow making money off their music. I don't know if like it was because it was a brand new album. Well, I do pay for a monthly subscription to Google Music, so hopefully they get a little bit of, I know that they don't get much, but for me to play that through Twitch as it comes through my phone speakers, like a really bad way for somebody to steal music. Alright, I'm stalling it, really. I'm ranting, but stalling mostly. Joseph. It's day. It's the day. Kind of left us a little high and dry with these guys. I tried to get them. I probably should have dropped all training activities. I said that last time. And I didn't do it. I didn't do it. Push the button. Push the button. This could be it. The Thor Thurl versus St. Jarnan. 288 make it out. For what could be the end of Tor Grieson's first as a professional basketball coach. His first in Iceland. Maybe he had some coaching experience before this. This is definitely his first in this league and his first on this scale. He did something in high school coaching or college, who knows. Fill in the blanks as you want, or we can have a little just chatting session. I can channel some kind of story for where Tor really came from. Stalling again, maybe? I don't know. I'm not sure if I'll be happy. I'm pretty sure it'll be exciting if I'm done now. It'll be exciting if I win and it goes to a game three, too. I'm telling you, I get excited. You may not. You may not even know. Maybe you're afraid that you just might. That's it. So they took turns on us. This game, it was Shouse's turn. The other fellows who have big games, Valdemarsson. There's two of them, and it's easier for me to try to keep track. But yeah, it's kind of a reverse of the cast. very likely last time you see Haldor Hermansson and Eliasson on the team. Good chance that some of these middle of the road guys will be going to that I haven't already signed. But Alderson should be back. Will be back, I'm pretty certain. Maybe we'll try to re-sign Cook. Johansson's a young guy, he should be back. He's part of the academy. Milomirovic. That brings it to an end. Playoffs, quarterfinals of the Icelandic League are completed. Asmundsen shows us that improvement. Now I don't know really what happens. See that there's a few games left to go. I'm getting choked up. My, I don't know. What to do with the training either, other than jack them all up, right? Is there a way to do all of them at once? Good enough. So how do I go about the rest of this? Without having to continue to go through that. So, season's over. I have some pre plan on deck. Thought that might happen. So, I guess that, I mean, this is as much fanfare as it's gonna get. I feel like maybe I could have at least done a off-season one first. But here we are. We're basically working at season two now. Inverting the colors like that, it gives it a nice brother love look there. This tie was red. I love you. That might be the last Bruce Pritchard impression for the day. But I guess let's make sure none of my guys are getting hurt. There they are. Moving on. Next round of playoffs is best 2 of 3, so similar couple and check, see where they're at. If you're just tuning in, the St. Jarnan, whatever their team is, the team from St. Jarnan has beat us. Our season has ended. That is why you are seeing the Season 2 graphic now. Although, Season 1 is still wrapping up to see who actually wins. As for now, we're going to swim a little bit. Do a little bit. I'm going to go like 3 days. The best teams play for each other, not with each other. You're supposed to be playing for each other, not with each other. It sounds like the point with the ding-dongs. You play with each other, play for each other. Which I guess is an important distinction to make. Stay focused. But if Bajo's watching, or sees this, or catch hears of it, tell him I changed my banner to not white. He didn't like that. Or either he didn't like that, or he didn't like the game having a load screen that was like, I don't know. I think he was taking a dig at me, but giving me a subtle suggestion for improvement. But then, I really feel like the graphic, I feel like Season 2 now, yeah, Tor Grieson maybe is a little flashier, maybe he is wearing the Brother Love outfit. He's got the early 90s WWF villain starter kit. And he's, you know, ready to try to get a push. This year was, I think, a feeling out. All things were felt. Let's take a look. Just some training progress here. Rebounding. Anybody? I put the team all I thought on. Maybe not these guys down at the bottom. Disregard. I set all the starters to defending and free throws. This youngster here, still not sure what chance he's got. He's working. That's all you can do. His inside scoring is not terrible and his free throws aren't bad. But this stuff's just not great. What else happened? And then Julius in here. Slight improvement in his rebounding on offense and defense. Much needed. His power's going through the roof. Should I keep developing it or shift focus a little bit? Defense isn't great. Free throw's not bad. Could build on that a little bit. Keep it like it is. don't know why it even matters to just some of these guys. One of the ones that will be with me next year. Not played yet? What the heck? May 9th, we go. We'll see the first round results. Or, I guess not the first round, first game of this round. Appear to be any train progress. Let's see what's happened in this first game of the semifinals. Imagine that KR is on their way. St. John is winning. That'll make me feel a little better if they get there, but still, it would make me feel better if I was walking those steps. And I feel like we could have. If Thomason had been there, maybe we would have. Ifs and buts are not candy and nuts. And the last one's the next game. 8 or 12. So let's check our fellows and it's almost like they're frozen or whatever their condition was or this, but even at that. May 13th. Yeah. Alright, I think we're getting close now. May 13th. Training progress reports. Kay Jensen, slightly better in his blocking. Do automatic. I think the computer kind of do what they want. Just try to keep them from getting injured at this point. So, let's see. KR has ended it for Grindavik. And St. John and Mustafa have one more to go. To earn the right to lose to KR. So it's the 16th. And it's up to the 18th. Seems like it takes an extra long time to load when you do multiple times. I don't know if in the aggregate it's less time doing them all back to back to back. It's supposed to stop and go, stop and go. I like to tweak the training plans, but you know, to this point, at this time of the season, do a
check in with the NBA League too. See what's going on with that mess with undefeated teams. Oh boy, KR and Scoffer. So St. John, it didn't make me proud. A bunch of things happen with people getting better. Let's just look at these. Gunnarsson. He's even going to be on my team next year. Anderson hopefully will be on my team next year. I'll change him to defending. He throws in a super. There's a lot of other guys up top. Not long, too much. Where are we supposed to get rid of that? Offensive rebound. His rebounding skills are going up quick. Starting to have some hope for this guy. Ian Arneson, slight improvement in his stealing ability. It's perfect now. You can work them.
May 21st, so a few days to go before they play. We'll come back on the 22nd. I wish I had some way of entertaining in between these long spells. I don't. Maybe start to invest in some kind of multimedia graphics or something, or switch to a cam or something to show me. I don't know. People want that? People really want to see me do anything? You want a cat or dog cam? Do that. You know, all the pets are in bed, but good boys and girls. Oh, man. He had all the drama of a winner-go-home game. And a long, grueling season on the line. And so, I don't know, maybe that just sucked the air out of the room. And so now, winding it down to see who wins just isn't that special. Maybe after this first game, just go ahead and send to the end of it. There's no reason to make me pop it in, working up my training. I've got them all pretty much on the right track now. Everybody's condition should be good enough. No freak injuries, I hope. Jameson should probably be approaching full health again. Thomason is back. Some kind of weird timer in my head. The fact that I was right. Okay. I'm not sure. Armerson, I think, is the last thing. So, Georgeson. Babyface kid, man. That's like junior high picture. I don't even remember where it said he got better at. Offensive rebounding. Marking. Keep up the good work, kid. Johansson shows a slight improvement in his marking. Nice. This guy's becoming like upper level defender for us. Quickness is still getting better. Speed there is not too bad. Trying to get his passing up, try to get him to be a little less of a liability on offense. It's all handled. Not too bad. It's a bigger fee. So, you know. Let's see what happens. was B. Ragnarsson, in his interview for a local radio station, pointed out that even though his love for the club is strong, he is a professional and his security and career come first. So maybe the end of his days with us. Ceiling ability of Gunnarsson is now slightly improved due to his training. Georgeson shows a slight improvement in his offensive rebound ability. The baby face again. Juliusson, why do I always do this? Shows a slight improvement in his power. This guy. I think I found, like, something to this game. If you can find one of their skills that's just gonna incline a lot, just ride it out. And at least have one skill that's all the way good, you know. The rest of his skills aren't great, but. Damn, he's been throwing people around. That's good for something, I guess. Rebounding is coming slow for him, so maybe I should switch to inside, and he's just going to be inside scoring. Free throw. Yeah, see what happens. Alright. Let's see what's going on in our league. KR got the first one by two. Closer than I thought. And KR, I mean, it's insane. Every time I see their roster, it seems like somebody else is running. But we're more or less the consistent one. Stephenson, I feel like, Julius Page. Snoffle was led by Crispin, Dapkus, Big Man Jones, some familiar names, people that have gave us trouble when we play. The next game is 25th. I'll step away while we load this one up. I'll be right back. Thank you.
Alrighty, alrighty. See what has happened here.
Couple training progress reports. Eliasson better in his blocking ability. That's nice. That's going to leave our team. And then the song, slightly better in his quickness. Those are all starting to look alike to me. Now tell me, this guy. Not the same. Okay, this guy. It's not the same. Then whites, and they all look alike. So, that said, KR put the beat down on that time. Stephenson again. Pavlovic this time. Like I said, they take turns. It's just hard to stop. Just curious where the heck this is, Bruce. Couldn't figure out what that team name was. Italian or Spanish? This fella. Humbelis Nassos. Confident that sooner or later the team will start to play better. Career scores. Not that bad, maybe. Look at the history here. Interesting, interesting. One thing I didn't do was check to see when this thing is over. 29th. So this could be the last game. I think that would be a perfect season for KR. This first season is shaping up to be just a global freak occurrence that one team and a couple of different leagues are going to finish the season completely undefeated. monster things just look like they broke loose. Anderson. Terrible blocking ability, got a little better. He's good. Omar soon. Quickness, it's a. Yeah, he's training for that. Quickness and speed, the guy's got a decent height. He's got to start developing something else. His free throw shooting is decent, it's getting better. I'm not able to finish drive. The ball game is terrible. Alright, Academy player Von Narsen will be 18 year old in a few days, and he must either sign a professional contract or leave the club. How's that? This will be 18. What? Seven, 18 and 8 months. Lots of questions now. I think this is all fair to assume means season's over. I thought it was that we're looking at losing. Don't think this guy's worth a contract. Okay. Not worth the contract. Okay. No, not worth the contract, right? I can't say that he's worth very little money. Maybe though. But no. Let them walk. I don't see them being major contributors. If I get hard up for players, I can come back around for them as free agents. Okay, look one more time. We've got a lot of guards, so he's the guy here. It's not quite as easy to say go away. He's got nothing offensively. He's slow. All right, I don't know what to do, really. I didn't say anything in here about...
I think that was the end.
I'm not sure what I'm listening to. Alrighty. Still waiting to see something, but instead I'm seeing all these fellas getting better. Ragnarsson. Jumping Bowie. 28 years old, is Jumping Bowie getting better? Maybe we should try to keep this guy. His defense, stealing. That's a bigger fee, sure. Johansson, his quickness, dude, he's ready. Isn't this the guy I just tried to, extend an offer? Good. Arneson, still young. What did he say? Slightly better than his marking. Good. Good. All these things are better. Wilhelmson's considering our offer. Just inch along one day at a time. Just until we figure what's going on with these academy players. Okay, everybody's getting better, just like in a hurry. I don't know if it's because they don't have anything else to do. All in perfect condition, so it's just grooving, right? You have 16-year-old guys. What do you say you got better at? Speed. Due to the strength or... His current rate, he'd be the guy you want to sign. Johansson's getting better and better. Rejected. Johansson's getting better and better, but he doesn't want to play for us. Ceiling ability. He's just turned into a defensive machine, too. Contract 3 years, season fee 20. Two. See if he likes that. Let's We're in the midst of the free agency offseason now. Again, the game doesn't really do anything, transition. It makes up some kind of bogus thing about your guys turning 18 in a few days. If you mean by like 8 months, some of the guys. Right. Some official information. KR is the winner. I think they lost the dang game. They got this team for a few years. Page was the MVP. <clears throat> 2017 Icelandic MVP. .4 points a game. He shot 4 for 6.8. Free throws weren't great, but that seems to just be a thing with this game in general. His rebounds, yeah, he had 5.4, 5.5. Managed to block a game, 2 steals, 2 assists. Congratulations. Bill Humpson considering an offer. I'm gonna let that soak for a second. I keep drinking this water very fast. I need some more. Thank you. Well, some good news to finally wrap into this offseason. We're going to have Bill Holmstrom for at least 3 years. The way he's progressing defensively, he's got decent height. We're overpaying him a little bit. I really think that after 1 or 2 years, it'd be worth more than paying. In that third year, we should get him on a discount at a good time. Looking at that second or third year, realistically, being some of my last, maybe. I'm going to topple KR or move on. That's the plan. Can I do that? Will I have the energy and the motivation to keep going? I don't know. I wish the game would give me some parameters about what to expect, how many more days of this, but I guess we can kind of fast forward now. The main guy I wanted to sign from that list of guys. Anybody else? Guy's defense is good enough. Got speed. Just because we have so many people in the backcourt already. I just don't think it's not gonna work. Then there's this guy who is—he's already at 18. I don't know. Do I have to sign him? Is he one of those people on that list? He was getting better all the time, but still, so far to go. I can't put on the court. Next, I do want to see what happened in the America USA League, also known as the NBA. Warriors Cavs, it appears. Warriors are up 2-0. Did the Warriors lose any game? No. Hmm. 107 seems to be their lucky number too. Beat the Cavs 2 times. 107 was the winning score. Guess that might be coming to an end soon. June 1st. Assimilate to June 4th and come back. See who the NBA champion. This might be it for tonight. I wanted to get all the way through, but
feel like this off season probably is worth its own night, one worth its own stream. Especially
put it out there for a day. These people want to come and help pick free agents, which guys to sign on my team and which ones to go after outside of our existing roster. Yep. Where are we at now? Rainson. So he got slightly better in his marking ability. That's good. Looks like the defensive rebounding ability came this on. Now slightly improved. Maybe a shrink, back to see. Pretty much seems like it's in the book that the Warriors. Yes, it appears. The Warriors are the champions. There you have it. Unless I get new Academy guys, how's that work? Do I get to pick them? lots of questions and answers that remain to be seen, decisions that need to be made. Just not 100% sure what the decision should be. Canada beat Japan, beat Qatar, lost to Canada, lost to Dominica, beat Kuwait. We're still waiting to see, will my national team ever play? Who knows? I guess I just jump another week and see if it does anything. And if it doesn't, then but this will probably be the wrap of the day. Pretty anticlimactic for all this time and all this work. It's just over. And then there's a lot of mystery, just not sure about how this game works. Kind of fast forward and simulate, but I don't know. I'm gonna miss something? Is there a day? Deadline somewhere? For what, I don't quite know. But we'll see if we can't go through the off season tomorrow. And that's kind of, I guess, the end of season one, kind of a season one finale. No, was this the season finale? Because I feel like I should have tried harder or something. I don't know. We lost, and that was it. And I was like, okay, well, let's see who wins, and I'll keep training guys. And then it told me I had to sign some of them. I'm like, shit. I'm ready to start spending money. But the fellow that we got, I think he can continue to develop into a good defender. And really, he should, in about 2 or 3 years, 3 years when that contract's up, be either on top of the league or considering his options for places to go, kind of like some of the young guns on our current team are with Eliasson and Hermanson, 19-year-olds, 20-year-olds who feel held back. So there are a lot of red dots on here now. Let's see. Pearson got slightly better. Let me tell me this. We've already made the decision. Going away for this guy. With that good height. It's just, we'll find somebody else. Free agent. Warnson, slight improvement in his quickness. And so now this guy has turned into a pretty good defender. Not really a scorer, that's for sure, but is he worth holding on to? He doesn't get paid much. Something to think about. And this Thorstenson, they're trying to get their lock, get their man locked up. Grindavik offering him 246k a season. Magnuson continues to get better. He might be to a point where he's worth keeping now. He's getting older though. I don't know, I'm going to keep him for more than 50. So, what else will be? Alright, now the reality of contracts expiring. Cook expires at the end of the season. If no new contract is signed, he'll be free to leave. Feels homesick. Power and the ball handling are declining a bit. Still a pretty good defender. Decent passer. Score. But man, he wants a lot. 167k. I don't know how hard it is to get guys to play in Iceland. Like, if I give them a contract, will I lose it just because of where I'm at? Because that amount of money can get me Zizic. It can get me a legit NBA caliber guy. Johnson has 23. Not a bad defender. He doesn't want much money. Can't do anything offensively. I guess this is what we're going to get for this price range. Just talking about Ragnarsson. That's too much. Gunnarsson. Look what he's doing with the 3 and D. Speed and quickness. He kind of wants a decent paycheck too. Just give him one. Because I did try to extend these guys, so he's just gonna want more than I'll float him. Let's try to transfer this thing. got hurt so many times. It's like, I want to keep him. I feel like he was decent. But he's expensive now. Let him walk. And we're just gonna bet that for that amount of money, I can get somebody for 144. One offer, one little ball offer. $130 per season. Let's see. It's like all the skills that he had progressed, he lost. See if we can get Elias in to stay. I don't know if we want him to. We've tried. I'm just giving him 1 year just to try to keep this team mostly intact. So I don't know if it's like open free agency now, just open hunting. So we'll see here pretty quickly what we got to work with and what we have to rebuild. But financially, there should be quite a bit of flexibility if these guys don't want to stay. Newspapers ran with all the news about guys being made available for transfer, Thomas and least, and all the offers being made. Lula Maravich saying he needs more time to adapt. Gunnarsson doesn't want to play with us. He's not so happy with the club. So Thomason's not sure that staying at the club will be the best move in his career. Eliasson has rejected. He's not sure that staying at the club will be the best move in his career. Reinsson desires a more active role. you're going to get it, man, because the whole team is basically gone now. Thorstenson got signed by Grinevik. So here's the thing with Reinsen, is if he gets a little quicker, he could probably play shooting guard. Ball handling's not terrible. So let's focus on the spreads. That would fill a big gap if he can play more than one position. And he can have a more active role, for sure. He's going to be here 3 more years. So, I don't know. I guess he just kind of ran into a wall there. Shut her down. We've got quite a bit of time left before next season. What exactly will be done in that time remains to be seen. There is no active schedule for the Icelandic team, and I don't fully know what I'm supposed to be doing with these contracts. Did I float a lowball contract out to Cook? I don't think we even tried, no. And she's getting paid. Can't afford that. That's 2 good players, possibly. Maybe 3. And so, let's take a look back at the roster as it stands now. With the expectation that Hermanson's gone. And probably Jornsson, Ragnarsson, Gunnarsson, Thomasson, Eliasson. Now these 2 guys. Reinsen, Vilhelmsson, Mulamerovic, Einarsson, Gustin. So that's 5. Got a starting 5. Good chance that Bjarnason, if he's still around, did I sign him? Because he's not going to want much. Let's do that. Three at 25 seems a little bit high for these guys, because he's not great, but by the time next season comes around, he'll probably be worth that, and then I'll have 2 seasons where he's bitching about contract stuff. But if he's continuing to progress, then great. This guy needs to get faster. No, speed isn't that bad compared to some of those other problems. Very low power. Aerobics. Jump, is that work? Like, I should just focus on defense so he can at least get on the court now. And I can sit here and screw with these things for hours, obviously, and days. It's going to turn into years now. Not quite sure where to go. What else to do from a schedule perspective? There's not a lot of information about what's going on or where to go from here. Still waiting for these contracts to fall off, the guys that. You know, if they're not here, then they're not here. How long before that becomes final? One more listening to. Like a mumble rap. I'm not sure if I listen to that right now. Actually, the good times have been had. Season's come to a close. Congrats to KR. Congrats to the first ever undefeated champions of the NBA, Golden State Warriors. I don't know how he were unable to lose a game. You did it. And so I'm going to just leave it at this for now. Pick it back up. Same time, same place. And see how far this offseason takes us as we try to figure out what we have to do to rebuild this roster. Just going to experience quite a bit of turnover. So all of that and more waiting for you next time. Until then, thanks so much. Thanks so much.